Whether it's a new SSD that you're setting up for the first time or an old SSD that you're saying sayonara to, knowing how to format your SSD will come in clutch. Today, I'll walk you through it. This is DIY in 5. Hey everyone, this is DIY in 5, the show where we give you the know-how you need to tackle tech projects yourself, all in a video that's 5 minutes or less. I'm Trisha Hirschberger, and today, we're formatting SSDs. I'll walk you through what it is and all the steps so you'll be set up in no time. Let's dive in. When you get a new drive, you may want to format it to ensure compatibility with your system. If you're repurposing an old drive, you may want to reformat to erase whatever was on there before, data, partitions, etc., and start anew. When you're getting rid of an old drive, you may want to do this to fully wipe the drive of data before you hand it over to the next owner. Note, there are more thorough ways to do this, and if you're concerned about the security of your data, look into more secure methods of erasing your disk. With that being said, let me be very clear to point out that formatting your SSD will erase all data previously stored there, so be sure to back up anything that you want to keep first. Baldur's Gate 3 save files, you're staying with me. When you format an SSD, you'll be asked to choose a file format for the drive to use. The most common options include NTFS, the format used by default when installing Microsoft Windows. It's got a very large max file size, but is read-only on Mac OS X without third-party software. For my iFriends out there, APFS is the native solution for Mac users starting with Mac OS 10.13, but here, Windows will not be able to use this file system without third-party software. For my Linux fans, ext4 or ext4, fourth extended file system, is the Linux default. Then there's FAT32, compatible with Mac, Windows, Linux, gaming consoles, and other devices with a USB port. The drawback to FAT32 is that there is no security, and file size is capped at 4 GB. XFAT is another option, and while it is compatible with both Mac and Windows, older systems may have a harder time with it. No file cap size though, so that's a bonus. Before we actually walk through how to do this, I want to offer another reminder in big, bold, capital letters that formatting your SSD will erase any contents stored there. So back up any data you want to keep. Use a nice external drive or the cloud or whatever works best for you. Once the drive has been reformatted, it's almost impossible to recover any data. I say almost because it's always better to be safe than sorry, and if you have something really private or sensitive, I'd encrypt that data first before erasing it. You could also secure erase using your BIOS or your SSD management software, such as the Kingston SSD Manager, just to, you know, be extra careful. All right, enough prep, let's do this. To format your SSD on a Windows device, simply right-click on the Windows Start button and head to the Disk Management tool. Right-click the partition or drive you want to format and then select Format. Select your file system and allocation unit size, then select Quick Format. On a Mac, the easiest way to format an SSD is using Disk Utility, which can be searched in Finder. Select your SSD from the list on the left and click Erase. Type in a name for the drive, select a file system, and select Erase again. If you are specifically formatting a drive for a Time Machine backup, you will need to pick APFS if using Mac OS 10.13 or later, or Mac OS Extended if using Mac OS 10.12 or earlier. And that's that. Your drive is set up and ready to go. Overall, formatting an SSD is a pretty quick and simple process that you should now feel ready to do on your own. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments, and myself or someone from the Kingston Studios team will get back to you. Thanks for watching, everyone. Like the video, sub to the channel if you learned something new, and I will see you next time with more DIY in 5.